Okay, myself Shital Raut, and I am representing the VNIT Nagpur. Sorry, I could not prepare a PPT. I will just show all the. So, we will start with the syllabus.
Third semester CSE.
Yes. We don't have any programming in first year. It is started now onwards for the next session. But right now we have a pattern like this. In the second year, we are introducing the subjects of programming to the various branches. For CSE, we have this one third sem CSE, introduction to the programming. In continuation with that, we have an introduction to the object oriented methodology for the CSE students. Then for electronic students, we have this programming in C and C++, that is again introduced on second year level. Then we have a computer programming for metallurgy and all the other branches.
So you have actually three different flavors of programming.
Yes.
One for metallurgy, mechanical engineer and lesser mortals of the world.
Yes.
Then the next higher level of human beings whom you recognize as electronics, you give them programming in C and C++.
That is the combination.
And to the Brahmins of the institution, you give introduction to programming and introduction to object-oriented programming. Is that acceptable to the general this thing? Because everywhere else we have seen that they have a common course for all branches of engineering.
At the second year level, we are introducing a Pascal language to the CSE students.
Okay.
We are the building blocks for the student logical level.
But that is CSE students.
Yes, CSE.
I am talking about the other branch students.
They are having just a flavor of programming in terms of C.
Okay. Mm-hmm. But there is no common course of programming to all students.
But from July onwards, that is the new introduction to the syllabus.
Uh-huh.
It is there for all the branches.
Okay, that's the first semester course.
But at the first year, we are introducing a C. Hmm. But CSE student, they are learning C language in a first year, but in a second year, they are learning a Pascal.
No, forget CSE students. We are not looking at CSE students at all. Mm-hmm. We are looking at engineering students of all branches,
mm-hmm.
which also include CSE.
Mm-hmm.
So therefore, what our interest would be, the first course that you are planning to do from July.
Mm-hmm.
Now, which particular subject of this overlaps on that course? Do you have any?
Actually, what happened? The third sem metallurgy is there.
Huh.
Then the third sem ETRX and ETC, they are having about
C and C plus plus.
C and C.
So you come made
C++ plus is not there.
That's okay. C. So the first year course now that is planned is C programming course.
Yes.
Okay. But it is the first course in programming.
Yes.
Can we assume therefore that it will run similar to your introduction to programming in CSE?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So it is 3028, no?
3028.
That means.
Sir, it's about a scheme.
Huh.
I'll just tell you the scheme of CSE and that to follow for all each and every branch. So introduction to the programming is the name of a subject at the second year level for CSE students. The credits are like this, 3 are there for a theory, then 0, though there is no practical as per the request of tutorial, as per the request of the students we can have that. Then we have a practical of 2 hours per week and the total credits awarded are 8 there. Now again for theory we have a 3 hours per week, for practical we have a 2 hours per week, each student is having that much, that means total of 5 for programming. And awarded credits are 8. Like this, the same thing is happened for object-oriented methodology, but here we are introducing one tutorial.
In fact, we should not discuss those other courses because what we are talking about is just the first course in programming. So, let's stick to that introduction to programming.
Okay.
I believe that is the course with which you are dealing with in your further details right now.
So, this is the evaluation pattern. We have a theory of 100 marks and practical is of 50 marks. Then again, what happened in a total semester, the period of that particular semester, we are getting 40 to 42 lectures. Why? Because the duration is approximately 4 months. Then the grading for theory is like that, it is splitted 15 plus 15 for the first sessional, next 15 for the second sessional, 10 marks is for class test. And it is depend upon that subject teacher, I will get for a 10 marks. It may have about class discussion of students and teacher, how they will convert a 10 marks. We can have a multiple objective question, then open book test. Again, for first sessional and second sessional, the option is open for a teacher. We can take, we can conduct a test just as a normal, or we can have an open test like that. 60 marks are awarded for an end semester examination. So together we have a scheme of 100 for a theory. Then attendance is having the grading scheme, no marking at all. So H is there for the highest, then 9, 8, and W is there for less than 75% attendance. Then for practical, we have a continuous evaluation. Again, in our computer lab, we have a 20 to 22 computers, and there is a batch of 15 students. Again, the assignments are given, and what happened in our practical one, we have a that subject teacher, and it is supported with two teaching assistants, which are basically MTech students. And at the time of evaluation, whatever be the deadline is there for submission, we take a Viva usually, and that will be a continuous assessment. So whatever be the marks are awarded, that is finally converted out of 50 then. Sir, actually this is the syllabus for CSC students. Books and references are there, and it is totally to the hands of teacher. What are the books? Then this is the subject for the fourth semester. We are introducing here a C++ flavor, and somewhat to the Java extent, the practicals are taken in.
Oh, you use Strawstrop, is it?
Yes.
I just go down to this introduction to programming course. So you do actually start with the basic internal architecture of a computer with ALU and memory and so on.
And okay. We have this programming with Pascal. In a fourth semester, we have concept in programming language.
So this you use Pascal, is it?
Yes, sir. We are using the Pascal here. Then at the fourth semester, we have a concept in programming language.
That's a programming language course.
Concept.
I know, but I'm talking about programming, not programming language. Here you use Pascal as a mechanism.
As a mechanism.
And you are anyway covering the basic data structures, so types and arrays and some algorithms, sorting, searching.
It is more to the ground level, that's why we are adopting a Pascal. And C and C++ is side by introduced there. Numerical programming is there, and where you have to what? You have to just convert the logic of your Pascal to a C and C++.
That so is a lab or that's a separate course?
It is a parallel courses, numerical programming and all that.
In the along with the introduction to programming.
Yes.
But now in the new syllabus, everybody will be doing introduction to programming in first year.
In the first year. And in they will C be, only, sir.
They will be doing C programming, but they will essentially be doing exactly the same thing. Arrays and
80% the same.
Yeah, I mean the concepts that they will be learning. See, programming language, according to me, as I said, and according to most of us here, is completely irrelevant. In fact, we do not have mention of C or C++ or this ordinarily, or as I said, Oracle or whatever. So the course name here is like Introduction to Programming. It's called Programming and Utilization, Computer Programming Utilization. Basically, you will be teaching them some simple data structures, data types, control structures, and the programming language chosen to explain this will be C. I think this is an important point that we should all start making in our course. By nomenclature, in practically most places, the course is known as C course or C++ course or Pascal course or COBOL course or something. It is detrimental to the notion of learning and teaching programming. And that is acknowledged universally except in India. So we have to actually force this philosophy of nomenclature amongst ourselves as also amongst our students. What we are teaching is programming. It so happens that we are teaching programming using C or Pascal. It doesn't matter really. So when you said they have to convert the logic from Pascal to C, that problem is treated as a trivial problem. In fact, I need not have a course in C. What is our expectation, you know, at the end of the first course? Suppose earlier we used to teach procedural programming, use Fortran, didn't matter what we use. We said that once you know procedural programming concepts, then no matter which new programming language is required to be learned, within 7 days and 7 nights, you should be able to write good programs in that language.
So, we are
that should be
the same thing for our student also. Correct. You just learn the methodology of any programming
correct.
And you can.
But here you are still using Pascal.
Yes, sir.
That is out of fashion at most places. There is one colleague of mine.
But that is the fundamental block. Because the students who are out of the CSE, they are the founder for the new languages. They are not a user. I think so.
Well,
we should know the ground reality.
The ground reality is not necessarily Pascal. That way, procedural programming, Fortran outdates Pascal by several decades. Not several decades, at least one decade. At least 8 years.
So Pascal is a benchmark.
No. Pascal is not a benchmark.
Fortran is far away, but Pascal is.
You can see you have hit a nest of bees by raising this issue, because 10 people here would have 10 different opinions. In IIT Bombay, the only person who would love you for saying this is Professor Rajiv Diwan, one of the best algorithms expert and one of the best theory guys in the country and probably in the world, and who still writes programs in Pascal. The point is, if you have a competition with him in writing programs in C, he can beat you most easily in C. He can do that in any other programming language. And that is the strength.
Definitely.
So, actually, programming language, we should not even consider it as relevant unless the programming language is so bad that it cannot enunciate and obviously bring out the basic concepts of programming.
Hmm.
Your answer to my Fortran thing should have been that Fortran might have come before Pascal, but it is simply not well structured in the original form. However, Fortran 90, if you see, is as good as Pascal in control structures, as good as this thing in there. Do you know that the country's first railway reservation system on deck machines was written in Fortran? You and, not you and me, but our elder relatives did their railway booking using a Fortran system, because they decided to buy a PDP 1170s or something, and they found out that the COBOL compiler runs slower than Fortran compiler on those machines, on the deck machines, and they found that the Fortran machines permitted use of indexed and relative files. So the deck Fortran had these features, and they decided to use Fortran to implement a first-class business application. So that is why I'm just going to say that language is important, but it's not the most important. Anyway, so this.
Actually, approach of our department is like that: ki we want to create something. Other people are learning a language; they are from also BA, BCom, and all that background. But if you are from a technology and that is based to a computer science, then you must be a creator of a new language. You thought like that.
No.
You are not just a user.
Sir, I would like to comment.
Anyway, I think we'll postpone this discussion for the pedagogy thing, because what she is saying is all relevant there. Do you have a question paper sample chance?
Yes, this is the paper for our 15 marks assessment. So no marks are given. It is totally in the hands of teachers.
No, but students must know now how many marks
sir,
are going to be.
They
don't know.
They know the practice of teacher, how they are teaching in a classroom and what how he evaluate the thing.
Okay, but
so it is not compulsory to give the mark.
Agree, but should I not know? It is like changing the goalpost after I have made a goal. So you're saying that you made a goal there, but the goalpost is here.
Sir, they are known.
Okay.
Own patterns are there. That's
okay,
why
that's
no problem at all.
That's okay. That's hardly matter. But you see, this is the kind of pattern, by the way, which is followed in IITs and IISc. So straight away, you you can see now that each question is actually enunciating some programming concept behind it also. And you definitely don't repeat questions, right? Or you do?
No, sir. We are not repeating the previous.
But then you might be repeating it by mistake.
But every time, sir, we are not facing any such problem.
Okay. Good. Which one is this?
This is end semester examination. Again, open book tests are there.
You do have a sort of theory question there where you are explaining how sparse matrix would be handled.
Mm.
Okay. See, you have further this thing. This, by the way, is very interesting. Consider the following Pascal-like program. So, no claim is made that the program is exactly correct as per Pascal syntax. But you see how important programming concepts come out. So that is why I say that language is not, it is important, but it is not the most important part. Anyway, but here some teacher has decided to give marks, which I like. Okay.
So marks are there for external. In our department, we already know that what should be there. Students are also known. So these are the assignments like this. Right now, I don't have an introduction to the programming, but it is the part and parcel of this. Yeah? So this kind of assignment we usually give, and the submission dates. If you see that the submission dates are already there.
Oh, so these are actually dates given. When you allocate the assignment, you give the dates. Mm-hmm. And they actually have to write the programs during their lab or whatever.
Sir, they are free to implement that particular concept. According to the given assignment, they are...
What do they submit? They submit the program listing and some documentation.
They either submit a program or whatever be the nature of that particular assignment is there, okay. According to that. Okay. We usually take a Viva in laboratory.
Oh, hash table in the first programming course? No, it is fifth semester.
I don't have that assignment.
No, that's okay. That's.
Sir, in the lab we have that dually operated operating system.
I read that. You had actually put it up there. Mm-hmm. You have Linux and Fedora on your desktop. So. And what servers do you use at the back end?
Sir, for programming we don't need like that.
Huh.
But for other purpose we have a different server and different backing system.
So, for example, if you want to give a programming assignment to the lab, mm-hmm. it will have to be loaded on each individual machine if you don't have a common server.
Sir, it is actually, the setup is there in the lab. Mm. We don't have to worry at all.
No. So, what is that setup, I want to know? Means, do they use any?
Windows 2003 server is
servers there. Are there. Mm-hmm. Okay. But can they be used as file servers, for example?
Yes.
And the number of teachers you mentioned,
and each lab, each classroom is having LCD. It is fixed.
How many students do you have?
Sir, right now 60, but 10% will be increased.
No, but this 60 is for CSE.
Yes, sir.
Consider the first year programming course which you will be teaching from July.
For each branch. Sir.
So, how many branches you have? Five, sir, I think. Six.
Only a civil is there for 30. Rest all the six branches are having a 60 capacity.
So, about 400 people.
Yes, sir.
And these 400 people, how will you run the lab, or that is being planned as you...
Sir, each department is having their own laboratory.
No, first year course, computer programming course.
Yes.
So, each department will run the lab separately.
Sir, we are actually planning that way only.
Yeah, but who will coordinate it then?
Sir, one of the professors.
So, how many teachers will be teaching this course?
Four. We plan four.
Four teachers to 400 students. Means 50-50, you will make 8 batches or something.
Yes,
and each teacher will teach 2 batches.
Yes.
And you will have ME, MTech students as TAs for the lab work. But the same teachers will not necessarily conduct the lab, is it?
No, sir. Actually, the work of teacher is very small. The MTech students are handling the laboratories and all that matters.
Okay. But who decides the lab assignments and things like that? That must be teachers.
That subject teacher will be deciding.
Correct. So, about 4 teachers.
Mm.
Okay, thank you.